Hello everyone, welcome to AVLSI lecture number 40.3. Today we are going to discuss about a new topic, that is folded cascode op-amp with differential output. So let's begin. So let's say that why we require, first of all, let's see the necessity of a folded cascode op-amp. So first of all, it will alleviate the drawback of limited output swing, which was a drawback in case of telescopic cascode op-amp. And also it will alleviate the difficulty in sorting the input to the output. Remember, we have said before that telescopic cascode op-amp is normally not preferred for unity gain buffer configuration. So these two problems can be solved by using a folded cascode op-amp. So first, let's recall our folded cascode circuits. So over here, we have a NMOS cascode amplifier, right? So what we do in a cascode amplifier, we stack one transistor over the other, right? So your M2 is stacked over the M1. And your I1 is my ideal current source load. And how do we make the same circuit in folded cascode manner fashion? So the folded cascode circuit will not stack the cascode transistor on the top of the input device. So basically the M1 and M2 are folded in such a manner that the current flowing through M1 and current flowing through M2 will be slightly splitted. So your input device is your PMOS and your M2 is my NMOS. So it's called as a PMOS NMOS folded cascode amplifier. It will provide the same gain, right? But it will eliminate the drawback of stacking the transistors one over the other. So here we have two different current paths. So one current is flowing through M1 transistor and other current is from M2 transistor. And those addition of them is I2 current, right? And it uses your PMOS, NMOS combination. We can have another combination also. This is my PMOS cascode amplifier, right? With a PMOS input device. And similarly, we have a corresponding NMOS, PMOS folded cascode amplifier. You see, we have a current source over here, I2. And from here, we have a NMOS device, input device. And here we have a PMOS device M2 and output is taken from over here, right? So here we can have the flexibility of sorting the input and output very easily. So this folded cascode concept can be extended to differential pairs and hence op-amp as well. So let's start. Yeah. So the circuit to the left-hand side A is my telescopic cascode op-amp, right? Now you must be wondering why I have drawn over your ideal current sources. So we have drawn ideal current sources for simplicity, and then we will build up on that, right? So I1 and I2 are my ideal current sources. It's my differential output telescopic cascode op-amp. So we have input devices in the form of M1 and M2. Now, if I have to convert this into a folded cascode op-amp, how it will look? So we have used over here a PMOS NMOS combination of a folded cascode op-amp. So what we do is we know that the current, we don't have to stack the transistor one over the other. So M3 and M4 won't be stacked over M1 and M2, right? That was a cascode op-amp. But here we have a folded cascode op-amp. So here we take the tappings from over here, right? So we have over here, first of all, the current source ISS, right? And that current source is splitting the current ISS by 2 through M1 and M2 PMOS input devices. So input is applied to the gate terminals of M1 and M2 PMOS devices. And that is taken across over here like this, right? So it's not completely stacked. And here we have a current ISS1 and ISS2, ideal current sources again provided over here. And here M3 and M4 is as it is from the circuit in the left hand side. So from M3 to M4, from the top, okay, from the top of M3 and M4, everything remains the same. Only thing is that how we connect M1 and M2 input devices. So that is connected in the folded cascode format. So this is my folded cascode op-amp with ideal current sources. So let's analyze this a little bit detail. So the current ISS/2 and ISS/2 is flowing through M1 and M2 transistor, right? So what is the current flowing through M3 and M4? current flowing through M3 is I1 because it's a constant current. So ID3 will be I1. And what is the current flowing through M4? The current flowing through M4 transistor will be I2. So ID4 will be I2. If you see carefully over here, your ISS1 will be the addition of I1 plus ISS2, correct? And your current ISS2 will be the addition of I2 plus ISS2. So that's the difference over here. The current to each part is different, right? That is what we have described over here, just that ID1 and ID3 will be equal to ID1 and ID2 will be equal to ISS2. Actually, over here, the current I1 flows through M3 and M1 transistor in case of telescopic cascade op-amp, and I2 is equal to same as ID4 and ID2, and that is equal to ISS2, right? So this was the bias current. It provides the drain current for both input and both the input devices. In case of a folded cascade op-amp, your ISS1 will be ISS2 plus ID3, as we have discussed over here. And ISS2 is nothing but your ID4 plus ISS2, right? So one drawback of folded cascade is that since the current requirement is slightly higher, we have a slightly higher power consumption. Okay, so it consumes a little higher power, folded cascade op-amp. So the advantage of folded cascade op-amp is reduced number of transistor stacking. Okay, so as you can clearly see, your M3 and M4 are stacked over M1 and M2, right? In telescopic cascade op-amp, whereas in folded cascade op-amp, they are not at all stacked over each other, right? So what is the advantage of that? The advantage is that it will have a much, much higher output voltage swing. Okay, so in the next case, what we will do is we'll replace this ideal current sources with actual MOSFETs, right? So let's proceed forward. Yeah, so we'll replace this I1 and I2 with transistors now. And another advantage of a cascade load is that it will have a high R out leading to high voltage gain. So this is my folded cascade op-amp with cascade PMOS loads with a differential output. So here it is. This is my folded cascade op-amp with differential output, right? So if you identify carefully, your load, which was earlier a current source load, now it's filled up by a PMOS cascade load. Okay. So M7 to M10 is my current source load, PMOS current source load. Okay. And remember ISS1 and ISS2, right? So they are also replaced by transistors which are biased in saturation. So that will provide a constant current. So it's the same circuit. Only thing is that your ideal current sources are replaced by actual MOSFETs. So first of all, your PMOS current source, we have a ideal current source replaced by a PMOS cascode, PMOS cascode current source load, that is M7 to M10. And your ISS1 and ISS2 is also implemented by M5 and M6. So M5 and M6 require the biasing VB2 so that they operate in saturation. Similarly, M3 and M4, M7 and M8, and M9 and M10 will require external biasing. Also M11. Because M11 was also an ideal current source, we have replaced that by a PMOS transistor, right? Working in the saturation region. So here we say that M5 to M10, M5, M6, M7, M8, M9, M10, replace the ideal current sources in the previous circuit over here, right? So here we have ISS replaced by a PMOS device. I1 and I2 are replaced by a PMOS cascade loads, current source load, and ISS1 and ISS2 are also replaced by your NMOS transistors, M5 and M6. Your M1, M2, M3, M4 will form a PMOS and MOS folded cascade combination. And M5 and M6 will provide the biasing for the folded cascade. So over here, ISS 1 and ISS 2 was providing the current biasing for the folded cascode. And in this case, M6 and M5 will provide the biasing current. And M7, M8, M9, and M10 formed a PMOS cascode load. And transistor M11 is biased by VB5 biasing to provide a constant current ISS, right? And we have a differential input in the form of Vin1 minus Vin2. Now let's proceed forward. So the maximum output swing of the circuit is discussed next. So we are calling VOD as my overdrive voltage of my transistor. So what will be Vout1 minimum? So Vout1 minimum will be overdrive voltage for M3 plus overdrive voltage for M5. So here it is, Vout1 minimum will be VOD3 plus VOD5. Similarly, Vout1 maximum value will be VDD minus overdrive voltage of M9 minus overdrive voltage of M7. So it will be Vout1 max will be VDD minus mod of VOD9 minus mod of VOD7, right? So overdrive voltages of M9 and M7 transistor. So your peak to peak single ended swing will be Vout1, which is Vout max minus Vout minimum. That will be Vout1 will be equal to VDD minus 4 overdrive voltages. Okay, so this is my single ended swing. So maximum differential output swing will be twice this value. So it will be twice into VDD minus 4 overdrive voltages. If we consider all the overdrive voltages to be equal, then it will be twice VDD minus 4 overdrive voltages, right? So in comparison to telescopic cascode op amp, the output swing is less by the overdrive voltage of the tail current source, right? So that is the advantage. We have a very good, better voltage swing in comparison to telescopic cascode op amp. So yeah, so what are the advantages of folded cascode op amp? First of all, no stacking of cascode on top of the input devices. Secondly, it has a large output swing that is twice of VDD minus 4 overdrive voltages. So these are the two advantages. Now we have to estimate the voltage gain of the circuit, right? So again, it's a differential amplifier, right? It's basically, so we can apply the concept of, virtual short or AC ground. So we'll consider point P as my AC ground or virtual short, right? Because the current source, the voltage over here remains almost constant. So after we do that, we'll apply the half circuit concept, right? So we know that when we apply the half circuit concept, the supply voltages will be, VDD will be short circuited, right? So let's see that analysis. So we have applied the at node P, we have applied that half circuit concept. So we will estimate the small signal voltage gain now. So node P is considered to be as a AC ground. Let me copy that node P over here. So this is node P. Let me try to copy this node P downstairs so that, Yeah. So we have applied the half circuit concept at node P. So this was my node P. Yeah. So I'm only considering now, if I apply at node P, I'm only considering half circuit because the circuit is symmetric. Right? So I'm only considering M1, M5, M3, M7, and M9, right? So with that, we will start the analysis. We only want the Vout1, the voltage gain with respect to Vout1. And similarly, we can extend it to Vout2, right? So I have drawn the circuit now in front of you. So over here, node P will be considered as an AC ground. Then we have M1 transistor. Then we have M5, M3, M7 and M9 connected in series, right? And output is taken across Vout1. So if you look into output impedance and we check R out of A, it will be basically R out of A will be, it's a cascode, right? So R out of A will be GM7 into RO7 into RO9. And over here, bottom way, we go in this node. If you look into this node, it will be like two transistors over here, which gate terminal as your gate terminal will be grounded, right? Because it will be its constant voltage. And the source is also grounded. So the resistance and impedance looking into this will be RO5 parallel to RO1. Because here also we have source terminal as grounded, right? So it will be RO5 parallel to RO1. So what will be R out of B, right? So R out of B will be GM3 into RO3 into RO1 parallel to RO5, assuming that body effect is ignored. So the voltage gain AV will be GM1, which is my input device, into R out. And what is R out? R out A parallel to R out B, right? So we know that what is R out A and R out B? It is, GM7, RO7, RO9 parallel to R out B, GM3, RO3 into RO1 parallel to RO5, right? So this is my small signal voltage gain of folded cascode op amp with differential output, right? It will be applicable because it's a symmetric circuit, right? It's a symmetric circuit, right? M1 and M2, then M5, M6, M3, M4, M7, M8, and M9, M10 are all symmetric. So that's why this voltage gain, small signal voltage gain formula will stand also, right? So here we could have written over here, instead of M7, we could have written over here M8, RO8. Then here we could have written RO10. It means the same, fine? So here this is my small signal voltage gain of a folded cascode op amp with differential outputs. And if you see carefully, if you compare it with a telescopic cascode op amp, your folded cascode voltage gain is slightly lower, basically 2 to 3 times lower than the telescopic cascode op amp, but it gives you a good voltage swing, and that is what is we are looking for, right? So yeah, so that is all about your folded cascode op amp with differential output, right? So have a look at it. This is my circuit of my folded cascode op amp, and it provides you high gain. At the same time, it provides you a better output voltage swing in comparison to telescopic cascode op amp, right? So yeah, we have come to the end of this session, and we have covered today folded cascode op amp with differential output. Next time we will start with folded cascode op amp with single-ended output, right? So that's it for this lecture, and next time we will continue with a new topic. So yeah, until then, have a good day and thank you.